Hey, what's up, pyros? Hey, I was watching Cody B. Pyrotechnics' video on a fuse, building the Roman candle rack. Hey, that's cool, man. Professional and all that. But for you guys that don't really have the time to do all that and you want something quick and a little more portable, I tell you, this is the pyros best friend, man. I keep telling people this, a milk crate turned upside down. Now, see, with these, we'll get to this stuff in a minute, and we'll explain the torch, why it's lit, and then we'll explain why I have this. But basically, with a milk crate, you can see the holes here. Now, you see this five-ball candle here. Not only can you do Roman candles with this idea, and of course, you can do you can sneak in your rockets, but on the big bore candles, see, you got to make some cuts. But on the regular size candles, look, you can angle them this way, you can angle them this way, pretty much. And then what you do is you just take some, I mean, you can buy these at pretty much Harbor Freight, any hardware store for $3 or $4. And they're, you know, zip ties, all shapes and all colors, all sizes, you know. And you just zip tie your candles, you know, you run a zip tie here and then loop it back around to get to secure your angle. So if you wanted it like this, to shoot way to the left, you just zip tie it there. See what I'm saying? If you want this to go straight up, you know, you can zip tie it that way. If you want a sharp right angle on this one, you know, you can do it this way. But with this right here, you could use a serrated kitchen knife. I have actually done that. Matter of fact, I think that's what I did with this one here. I actually hand cut it. On the big bore candles, you got to have a bigger hole or they won't fit. But for the normal size candles, they will fit. But I mean, nothing substitutes a good sawzall, and this one's variable speed, so I suggest using a metal blade, so you can go slow, or you don't want to go too fast, you get the idea. Use a metal blade, and it'll give you a nice, clean cut on your plastic, see that? That's what I would do. And then, you can either, once you get all your candles ready to go, get your angles just right. You got them all zip tied, ready to rock and roll. Now you could do two methods. You could use a cake fuse or quick fuse. You can fuse up, you know, fuse all, just wrap your, you know, do all your fusing. Or what I like to do, since when normally on candles you got plenty, you got a good 7 to 8 seconds, 6 to 8 seconds from the time you light it to the time the first shot goes off. Because remember, it goes from the top down to the bottom. What I've done in the past, good old propane torch, you turn that sucker up like this. I'm not going to do it, of course, because, and then you just take it, and then you just go around all your Roman candles real quick. Angle it down, boop, 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 all the way around, and you'd be surprised. I think one time I got like 12 of them lit, right as the first shot was starting to come out on the first candle. I got 12 of them lit all at once. One time the first shot of the first one was coming out. So yeah, you could use a propane torch, you know, like so. I recommend either the automatic ones or this one here. You actually have to turn the gas on, but it's got the automatic clicker, which is pretty good. And then, like I said, you could do for the big ball candles, the big bores, like these Top Gun ones here, the Earth, Wind, Fire, and Water series. You're going to have to cut slightly larger hole, like I said. So, hey, the way Cody's, his way is, man, that's awesome. You know, you build a nice wooden one, and it's permanent, you know. You could take it out in the field. But if you're, this is something you can throw in the back of an SUV, and, you know, you can make your cuts ahead of time if you knew you're going to be doing big bores or regular candles. Like I said, the regular candles will fit right in there. See that? And the stock holes. They'll fit right in there with room to spare. And then you zip tie them. Like I said, once you get your angle, say you want it to go this way, you zip tie it, secure it, and you're ready to go. And then you just hit it with your torch, boop, 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 real quick all the way around. Or you use some quick fuse, and then you can actually fuse them. But I highly recommend getting one of these little cheap sawzalls. This is a little cheap Ryobi. This is a wood blade. You want to use a metal blade. You could probably use a wood blade, but it'll be all gnarly. It'll chew it all up. Or a good serrated kitchen knife. like I said, but anyway, it's just another option for you guys if you want to do your aromatic candles on the 4th of July or New Year's Eve or whatever. Milk crates are a pyro's best friend, man. There's so many options, man. There really is. You can see the holes in here. You can even put individual rockets. See what I'm doing here? You can put individual rockets in these holes here, and they go straight. Look at it. And they stand straight up. So the possibility, you could line this thing with rockets. See, that's just one hole. You can line this thing with rockets all the way around your milk crate, and then the middle will be all nothing but Roman candles. Of course, you don't want to zip tie a rocket. That would be kind of stupid. Uh-huh. But yeah, you can angle it this way. You can angle it that way. And you just zip tie it, man. But yeah, I highly recommend a propane torch. You know what I mean? Or some good quick fuse. But the torch works the best, man. Anyway, this is a little response video for Cody's video. Man, by the way, he rocks, man. Sub this guy if you're not already. He's a crazy old pyro like me, man. Two peas in a pod, man. But, oh, I love these TG candles. But anyway, you guys get the idea. You can put your, rockets. See that, man? You can put one here. You can put a rocket there. You can put a rocket here. You see what I mean? So as your candles are going off, you can sneak back in, hit this with a torch. You know, these ain't boom rockets. They're just good report rockets. Hit your rocket. Boom, boom, the rockets go up. You get your candles going up. You know, really, or you can just do the rockets first, or you don't even need rockets. Just use the thing for aroma candles. That's what I use it for, pretty much. But yeah, milk crate. Milk crates are awesome. Every pyro should have a milk crate in his stash. I mean, it doesn't substitute like a mortar rack or a good wooden Roman candle rack, but it's portable. It works. 10 minutes of work with one of these babies here. If you got a bunch of, if you just want to do all big bore candles, you could do that. But like I said, you're gonna have to cut a little bigger hole. But these, I got a Whistling Dragon here. I think this one's a little flashing, fireball, flashing thunder, and yeah, Whistling Dragon. Whistles and booms, consumer stuff, you know, nothing crazy. They're not that loud, but they're decent for what they are. Anyway, just a little tutorial, quick little video. Well, not quick, it's almost 8 minutes. But anyway, if you guys like it, give me a thumbs up. And if you got any comments or questions, leave them down below, let me know. But a good old milk crate, man. Every pyro, man, gets you a milk crate. Just, it doesn't substitute everything, but it gives you something else in your arsenal. You know, you can have two or three milk crates lined up across, and you could do some amazing things with it, man. Anyway, video's getting kind of long, so there it is, guys. But torch. Milk crate and a torch. That's all you need on your candles. And then remember, well, the zip ties. Don't forget the zip ties. Very important. You know, because these big boars, they'll jump around on you, man. They got some big oomph. They got some thumpage behind them. So they might bounce, they could bounce around in there. You don't want that. So, yeah. Get them all secured. There you go, man. Quick little substitute to Cody's video. But if I was you, do both. Have your milk crate and build the one Cody's built. Showed you guys on his video with the wooden one. It's a lot more professional. It looks nice, especially if you're doing it for money and you're going to someone's house. You know what I mean? It would look a lot better if you showed up with a professionally looking one made out of wood than it would to show up with this. But if you're just doing a little backyard show, you know, or going over a friend's house, neighbors, or your own yard, this works great. You can do rockets. Well, you see it, man. And just secure them with zip ties. That's all. Pretty cool. Yellow groove out, man. Take care, guys. Peace out. Pyros.